Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 12th of August. India's foreign minister holds talks with Chinese counterpart in Beijing. Afghan president calls for peace with dignity in Eid message. And Muslims across India and Pakistan celebrate Festival of Sacrifice. And now for all the details, Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, who is on a three-day visit to China, met top Chinese officials, including his Chinese counterpart Wang Li, in Beijing on Monday to bolster bilateral ties.
Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar met his Chinese counterpart Wang Yi in Beijing on Monday and held bilateral discussions. Jaishankar, during the meeting, said India's relationship with China has a unique place in global politics, and through years, leaders of both the countries have worked to recognize this reality. They also co-chaired the second meeting of the India-China high-level mechanism on cultural and people-to-people exchanges. The meeting will prepare the ground for the second informal summit between Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping, scheduled to be held later this year. The foreign ministers also addressed the media at the closing ceremony of the 4th India-China High-Level Media Forum organized by China Public Diplomacy Association.
The positive direction of our ties after the Wuhan summit has opened up a new world of convergences. Exploiting this and taking our ties to a new level will require strong public support in both societies. The media can make a major contribution to that goal.
Jaishankar, who is on a three-day visit to China, earlier met Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan and discussed strengthening of relations between the two nations. Jaishankar's visit to China comes amid heightened tensions between India and Pakistan after it revoked Jammu and Kashmir's special status. India had responded to China's objection to it, saying that it was the country's internal matter.
Crew members of an offshore support ship of the Indian Coast Guard jumped into the waters of the Visakhapatnam coast after a fire broke out on the vessel on Monday. An explosion was heard on the offshore support vessel Coastal Jaguar at 11:30 a.m. Minutes later, smoke billowed out from the ship, following which the crew jumped into the water to save themselves. Indian Coast Guard ship Rani Rashmoni, which was in the vicinity, rushed to the spot and rescued at least 28 crew members. Meanwhile, one of the crew members was still missing till the last reports came in. The exact cause of the fire is yet to be ascertained. And in news from Pakistan, the streets of Pakistan's Karachi city were submerged on Sunday as the megalopolis experienced heavy monsoon showers for a second consecutive day. Death toll in Karachi has risen to 11 as heavy monsoon rains have caused a critical situation.
At least 11 people, including a child, lost their lives in rain-related incidents in Pakistan's port city of Karachi. The streets of Karachi were submerged on Sunday as the megapolis experienced heavy monsoon showers for a second consecutive day. Downpours accompanied by thunderstorms caused flooding, inundating the city's low-lying areas and many homes. Rescue workers said at least 8 people were killed, mostly by electrocution. At least 6 cows for sale in the market for Eid were also killed by electric shocks.
कम से कम हमने 250-300 तक रेस्क्यू किया, 8 अफराद हलाकत हुई है, जो बिजली और मुख्तलिफ हलाके हैं जो बिजली की वजह से हुए हैं, लाइट की वजह से ज़्यादातर डूबने की कोई इतना बात नहीं है ऐसी।
हमारे बहुत जानवर हैं, वो परेशानी में, हम लोग जानवर को कहाँ खड़ा करें, इतनी हालत हो गए कि 2 से 3 मीटर पानी ऊपर आ चुका है। ईद उल अज़हा के मौके पे इतनी परेशानी का सामना करना पड़ रहा है हमें कि इंतजामिया भी नहीं है यहाँ पर, कैंप की इंतजामिया नहीं है, गवर्नमेंट इस वक्त कोई भी मौजूद नहीं है, हम अपनी मदद आप चल रहे हैं।
The authorities suspended electricity supplies to flooded urban areas after reports of water building around power installations. According to the weather office, Karachi was expected to receive intermittent rain during the next 24 hours, which could hamper Monday's Eid al-Adha, one of the two most important festivals of the Islamic calendar.
And in news from Afghanistan, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani attended Eid al-Adha prayers at the presidential palace on Sunday and called for a dignified peace. Ghani called on the nation to give authorities to the future president to make tough decisions with strength and dignity.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani attended Eid al-Adha prayers at the presidential palace on Sunday and called for a dignified peace. Ghani called on the nation to give authorities to the future president to make tough decisions with strength and dignity. He assured that peace is coming to the country and there is no doubt in it. The negotiations between the United States and Taliban, which began late last year in Qatar, have not brought a reduction in violence, with both the Taliban and Afghan government forces, assisted by US-led international troops, launching assaults against each other.
Sola de har Afghan gukhtanada aw sola ratun kid. Deki kum shak aw shubad ni ti sola ratun kid. Mar kum raqam sola. Haga sola ti paghi ke de har Afghan izzat.
Meanwhile, outside the presidential palace, Kabul residents gathered at a livestock market to mark the day by sacrificing animals and wished for peace and security in the country. Eid al-Adha, also known as the Festival of Sacrifice, is celebrated to commemorate Prophet Ibrahim's willingness to sacrifice his son Ismail on God's command. It also marks the end of the annual Hajj or pilgrimage to Mecca.
Sri Lanka's main opposition party on Sunday named hardline former defence chief Gotabaya Rajapaksa as its presidential candidate. Gotabaya vowed that if elected, he would prioritise Sri Lanka's national security and the revival of its economy, which has been hit after the Easter Sunday attacks.
Sri Lanka's main opposition party, Sri Lanka Podujana Perumana or SLPP, named a hardline former defence chief as its presidential candidate on Sunday, seeking to capitalise on public clamour for a decisive leader after the deadly Easter Sunday bombings. SLPP's candidate Gotabaya Rajapaksa served under his elder brother, former President Mahinda Rajapaksa, and is widely seen as the front-runner in a presidential election that must be held before December 9. 70-year-old Gotabaya is immensely popular among Sri Lanka's powerful Sinhala Buddhist majority, who credit him with ending the island nation's 26-year-old civil war in 2009. He vowed that if elected, he would prioritize Sri Lanka's national security and the revival of its economy, which has been hit by a lull in tourism after the attacks.
අපිට යලිත් මේ දිවයින ලෝකේ සුරක්ෂිතම රට බවට පත් කළ හැකි බව මම ඉතා විශ්වාසයෙන් ප්‍රකාශ කරනවා. ඔබේ දූදරුවන්ගේ ආරක්ෂාවේ වගකීම මා බාර ගන්නවා.
Sri Lankans are still reeling from the Easter Sunday bombings, which killed more than 250 people, shattering the island nation's decade of relative peace since the end of the civil war. Other parties have not formally announced their presidential candidates, but Gotabaya's main challenger is expected to be Housing Minister Sajith Premadasa, a centre-right United National Party politician who is also popular with hardline Buddhists.
Hindu devotees in Nepal and India thronged temples on the auspicious last Monday of the ongoing monsoon month of Shravan. Devotees seek the blessings of Lord Shiva for peace and prosperity of their families by offering special prayers during the holy month.
Scores of Hindus thronged the Pashupatinath temple in Nepal's capital Kathmandu on the last auspicious Monday of the Hindu holy month of Shravan or monsoon. Devotees stood in long queues outside the temple before offering water brought from sacred ponds and water resources to Lord Shiva, the Hindu god of destruction. Shravan, a month dedicated to Lord Shiva, is considered auspicious on its own, but Mondays hold special significance.
मैं इंडिया से आया हूं पशुपतिनाथ दर्शन करने के लिए दर्शन करने से लोग कहते हैं कि बहुत अच्छा होता है इसलिए आया हूं दर्शन करने सुंदरी जल गया था जल बोझे हैं और आया दर्शन उर्शन किए बहुत अच्छा से दर्शन हुआ है पशुपतिनाथ का कृपा रहेगा तो और अगली साल आएंगे
Meanwhile, similar scenes were witnessed in India's Kanpur city where hundreds of devotees thronged Anandeshwar Temple to offer special prayers to Lord Shiva and Shivling, his fellow's representation on the occasion. As part of the special prayers, they offered uncooked rice, flowers, fruits, and also poured water and milk on the Shivling.
सावन का आखिरी सोमवार है ये जो संयोग बन रहा है ये संयोग कम से कम 151 सालों बाद ये संयोग बना है और ये अंबार जो भीड़ देख रहे हैं बाबा के दरबार में इसको बाबा विश्वनाथ के बाद द्वितीय स्थान उत्तर प्रदेश में माना जाता है
Every year more than 5 million devotees from different parts of India visit temples over 30 days to pay obeisance to Lord Shiva during the auspicious month of Shravan During the monsoon festival, Shiva devotees also fast till dusk, eating only root vegetables and fruits.
Muslims across India and Pakistan celebrated Eid al-Adha on Monday with prayers and sacrificing animals. The festival of sacrifice is the second of Islam's two major religious festivals.
Muslims across India celebrated the festival of Eid al-Adha or festival of sacrifice on Monday with prayers and sacrificing animals. A huge gathering was seen at the famed Mughal-era mosque Jama Masjid in Indian capital New Delhi. People prayed, hugged and wished each other on the festive occasion. Eid al-Adha commemorates the Quranic tale of Prophet Abraham's willingness to sacrifice his son as an act of obedience to Allah. Before Allah replaced the son with a ram to be sacrificed instead. Muslims who can afford sacrifice animals usually goat or a sheep on the occasion as a memory to the incident.
इसमें हम कुर्बानी करते हैं और कुर्बानी का यह नमाज के बाद हमें कुर्बानी करनी है और उसका बेहतरीन मसला यह है कि उसके तीन हिस्से किए जाएं जो कुर्बानी का है उसमें एक हिस्सा अपने लिए एक अजीज व करीब के लिए एक गुरबा के लिए और हम इसमें कोई मसावात है किसी को भी दे सकते हैं
Devotees also offered prayers at neighborhood mosques in India's Jammu and Kashmir amid restrictions a week after the special status of the region was scrapped Restrictions that had been temporarily eased on Friday and Saturday allowing some bakeries pharmacies and fruit shops to open ahead of Eid were reinstated in major parts of Srinagar city on Sunday afternoon Meanwhile, in Pakistan, Muslims dressed up in new clothes congregated in mosques to offer special prayers on the occasion. According to religious belief, Eid al-Adha also coincides with the anniversary of the day when Quran, the holy Islamic book, was declared complete, and therefore many Muslims undertake Hajj pilgrimage to Mecca on this day.
Eid al-Adha, hamara jo hai, bahut bada mazhabi tehwar hai. اور اس پہ یہ جو عید ہے یہ ہمیں مذہبی ایثار کا اور قربانی کا جذبہ یاد دلاتی ہے
The festival of sacrifice is an important religious event that is celebrated annually on the 10th day of the 12th and the last month of the lunar Islamic calendar.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.